attending this three-day workshop with Noah at the Inouye Regional Center and He'ea Fish Pond, and then of course virtually, was a really valuable experience. There were so many experts and knowledgeable speakers to listen to and learn from.
We got to interact with fellow educators from different islands, and we also got to see some of the fun toys that Noah had. So some personal highlights were the Science on a Sphere, which is a giant 360 sphere that is suspended from the ceiling and has four cameras on it, and it rotates, and you can overlay different data sets on a rotating globe.
I also found the work with Thomas Oliver on the coral reef banners to be really effective, and I think there's plenty of opportunities there for us to work with that, to bring those into classrooms so that young people can engage with the banners.
Workshop that Celeste ran was a real treat because we got to step into the role of student. So she had an Ahupua'a lesson planned for us, and we all got to be different flora or fauna in the ecosystem and interact with each other and really take that student perspective.
One of the other beneficial things to come out of this workshop, I think, was learning about the Lenin kits and the grant opportunities that there are. So knowing that there is equipment out there to borrow, or with some purposeful planning, there are programs that take a look at your ideas and support you. One thing that resonated with me was this sense of building Pilina. Most of the speakers came back to this at some point in their presentations. And as educators, we know that building relationships with students is really important for learning. But then when thinking about inspiring environmental stewards, making sure students are connected to the aina, making sure students are observing relationships between species and ecosystems, observing those earth cycles, I think all of that is helpful and imperative to create change down the line.
Also, how we can bridge this ancestral wisdom and knowledge to help us today to develop greater community resilience and basically navigate climate change in a way that is sustainable and resilient and equitable for everyone. We had teachers who, you know, we spent so much time online together and on Zoom, but just hearing the stories, being able to walk around together, do some of the hands-on activities, participate in some of the games that we were playing. And, you know, that small talk is really important, being able to eat lunch together. And I'm hoping that we can, through this year and beyond, really build a community of practice around climate change education.
To learn more about our workshop content and resources, please make sure to visit us online. Also, we would welcome you to join our online climate change community of practice, where we can continue these crucial conversations. Mahalo.